हेलो ऑल, वेलकम इन वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन 8051 माइक्रो कंट्रोलर। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आउट अबाउट मेमोरी स्पेस एलोकेशन इन 8051 माइक्रो कंट्रोलर। प्रीवियसली वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हेन वी कंपेयर द 8051 माइक्रो कंट्रोलर विद दैट ऑफ माइक्रो प्रोसेसर, two striking features are supported by microcontroller. The first one is a inbuilt port and the second one is a inbuilt memory. In case of 8051 microcontroller, we have 128 byte RAM and 4KB ROM. So here in this lecture we are going to see how this 128 byte RAM is distributed in order to enhance the working capability of 8051 microcontroller. So, as we know, in case of 8051 microcontroller, we have total this 128 byte of RAM. Okay, and this 128 byte RAM is assigned addresses from 00H to 7FH. So, this is what this entire memory location, which is going to start from 00 and ends at 7F, this whole memory allotment or location is basically what a 128 byte RAM present in 8051 microcontroller. So as shown over here. So when we talk about this entire range, that is from 00H to this 7FH, this entire slot is basically what? Simple, the 128 byte RAM present in 8051 microcontroller. So in this video lecture, we are going to see how this 128 byte RAM is distributed in 8051 microcontroller as represented here. So basically, the addresses are distributed as per its total name given to it. So let us discuss this. Now, this 128 byte RAM, which is available in 8051 microcontroller, is mainly divided into three different groups. Okay, so this entire whatever the locations are there, which are going to start from this 00H and going to end at 7FH, that is 128 byte location, this entire 128 byte locations are divided into three groups. So the first, that is first 32 bytes, which are going to start from location 00H to 1FH as shown here. Simple, this 00H and this 1FH, that means this whole area, this specific area is divided or generally termed as a register bank. Okay, so what is this register bank? What exactly its content? That we are going to discuss in some later stages of this lecture. So at this instance, simple, whatever the 128 byte RAM is there with us, out of that 128 byte RAM, first 32 bytes, which are going to start from this 00 and going to end at 1F, are termed as a register banks and also for the stack memory as shown here. So register bank 0, bank 1, bank 2 and bank 3 means which are going to start from, total 4 banks are with us, which is going to start from this 00 and going to end at 1FH. And along with this, for this register bank 1 is also going to work as a stack memory. After this, the next 16 byte, which are going to start from 20H and going to end at 2FH as shown here, that is 20F to 2FH, this specific slot of memory, which is of 16 byte, is termed as bit addressable RAM. And the remaining 80 byte, which is going to start from 30H and going to end at 7FH, this last 80 bytes are mainly termed as a scratchpad RAM, which is used to store the data for temporary purpose. So location starting from 30H to 7FH, this location is basically called as a scratchpad RAM here. So let us discuss it in detail. So again, in a summary, total 128 byte RAM is present in 8051 microcontroller. This 128 byte RAM is distributed into three groups. The first group is called as a register bank, which is going to start from 00 to 1F, that is total 32 byte. The second slot is bit addressable RAM, which is going to start from 20F to 2FF, that is simple the 16 bytes of memory, and the last one, which is going to start from 30H and ends at 7FH, this is mainly called as a scratchpad RAM, and this is basically contains what the 80 bytes of memory is. So let us discuss it in detail. So the first, as said, out of this 128 byte RAM, the 32 byte RAM are set aside as a register bank, as shown here. So out of 128 byte, whatever the memory location going to start from 00 to 7F, out of that, the 32, that is 00 to 1F, these 32 bytes are set aside as a register bank. And the address, as shown here, is going to start from 00 and ends at 1F. So again, these 32 bytes are subdivided into 4 register banks, as shown here. Location 00H to 07H, these are the hex values, that is 00H to 7FH. This first 8 byte slot is termed as a register bank 0. The second 80H to 0FH is termed as a register bank 1. The third 10H to 17H, again the 8 byte is named as a register bank 2. And last, that is 18H to 1FH, this is, or this memory slot, these 8 different bytes of memories are termed as a register bank 3. In this way, 00 to 1F, these 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 slots are termed as a register bank 0, bank 1, bank 2 and bank 3. And each of this slot is again having the capacity of 8 bytes, means total 8 bytes are present in bank 0, 8 bytes are in bank 1, 8 bytes are in bank 2 and 8 bytes are in a bank 3. So in this way, 8 multiplied with 1, 2, 3, 4, so total 32 bytes are there with us, and these 32 bytes are termed as a register bank. So as discussed, each register bank consists of 8 registers, okay, so, and these are named as a R0 to R7 as indicated here. If we see 00 to 7F, so in this 00 to 7F, we have this 00, 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06 and 07. So from 00 to 07, we have these 8 bytes. So this is byte 0, byte 1, byte 2, byte 3, byte 3, means 1 byte location. And each of these bytes is termed as a R0, R1, R2, R3, R4 respectively. So means what it indicates? In bank 0, we have total 8 register. The first location, that is 00H, is termed as a register R0. 01 is termed as a register R1, 2 as R2, R3, R4 in this way. When I am going to switch towards bank 1, which is going to start from 08H to 0FH, this is nothing but what? 08 register R0, 09 register R1, 0A register R2, up to 0F register R7. And this bank 1 is also used as a stack memory. Similarly, in bank 2, which is going to start from this 10H to 17H, this also is nothing but what your bank 2, which is going to hold the register. Means each of this bank consists of 8 different bytes. Each byte is no doubt 8 bit wide, and each of this byte is termed as a R0, R1, R2 with its proper address. So when I'm going to focus here, total, in case of 8051 microcontroller, we have R0 to R7 registers which are present in bank 0, in bank 1, in bank 2 and in bank 3 in this way, okay, whose starting address is 00 and end address is 1F. In this way, this total, say, 32 bytes are divided into sub register. Okay, and by default, when we go for a programming, this bank 0 is used. So if I am going to use a notation simple R0, then what will happen? We are going to access by default this memory. Why? Because the bank 0 is selected by default for the operation when we turn on this microcontroller. And there is one register that is known as a PSW that we are going to discuss later on. With the help of that register, we can switch from one bank to another bank. Okay, so again, what it indicates? Simple. Suppose I am writing a simple instruction, and that instruction is, suppose, move R0 comma hash 0.05h. What this instruction do? It is going to copy the data 0.05h into R0 register. So the moment at which we write this instruction, then what will happen? The value 0.05 is copied into this R0 register. And where is that R0 register? To this location directly. So the value 0.05 is get copied into this register. Why? Because by default the bank 0 is selected. So from this bank 0, the register R0 is used. If I am writing, suppose in this way, move R7, hash 09H, then what will happen? This value, that is 09H, is get copied into R7 register. Means the value 09 is stored to memory location 07H, which is nothing but what? The register R7. So in this way, these register banks are present in 8051 microcontroller. And all these registers, say R0 to R7, all these registers are basically what a general purpose registers. Next is bit addressable RAM. So out of this 128 byte memory, the 16 bytes are set aside as bit addressable RAM. The location, that is the memory in 128 byte, the memory location starting from 20H and going to end at 2FH, this entire slot of memory is mainly called as a bit addressable RAM. And these total 16 bytes are having 128 bit, and each of this bit is having a specific address attached to it. And why it is called as a bit addressable RAM? Because from this 20H to 2FH, each of this location is having a certain address assigned to it. That means for 20 we are having this address. So 20, again this one slot consists of 8 bit, and each of this bit is having some unique address. So directly I can use this address for programming. Means individually, if I'm going to focus on the previous discussion, that is in a R0 R1 register, simultaneously we are using one register, and one register is of 8 bit wide. So in short, what? When we are accessing a register from register bank, simultaneously we are dealing with the 8 bits. But in this case, from memory location this 20H to 2FH, instead of dealing with entire 8 bit, directly I can program a single bit. So that's why it is called as a bit addressable area or the bit addressable RAM. And each of this, for example, I can utilize some instruction, and with the help of that I can directly access only one bit, which is present at memory location 44H here. So that's why it is called as a bit addressable RAM. So we can read or write any single bit from this region by using some unique address that are associated with this bit. So suppose I want to access this last location, which is say simple my 78H. Okay, so directly by using a specific instruction, I can execute or I can update the data present at this specific memory location. And the last one is a scratch pad RAM. So out of 128 bytes, 80 bytes are set aside as scratch pad RAM, and its address is 30H to 7FH. So out of this 128 byte RAM, the location which is going to start from this 30H and ends at 7FH, this entire memory location is mainly known as a scratch pad RAM. So these 32 bytes can be addressed directly or indirectly using direct or indirect addressing mode respectively. So we may read or write full 8 byte, that is 8 bit full byte, that is 8 bit data from these locations. Okay, for example, I am going to write one instruction, and that simple instruction is what? Here, move R0, hash 35H. This first instruction I am writing, and now I am going to write a second instruction, that is move R0, 35H. Okay, so at basic level, the main role of this instruction is what? No doubt, as we are using the move instruction, so this instruction is going to copy the data from source into this destination. Say move destination comma source. So whatever the data that represented by source, that is get copied to the specified destination. Now when I am going to compare this instruction with this instruction, in declaration we find the difference that the hash sign is present in this first instruction, whereas this hash sign is absent into a second instruction. So what will happen because of presence of this hash sign? So the moment at which any number we mention along with this hash sign, that number is considered as 8 bit data, or that number is simple considered as a data for processing. And if hash sign is absent, then this number is treated as simple the memory location address. Okay, so finding the difference between these two instructions, here the 35 is treated as data. Why? Because this 35 is mentioned along with this hash sign, whereas this 35 is considered as a memory location address. So what will happen when we execute the first instruction? Okay, so before that, consider this memory location that right now we are discussing. The memory location is going to start from, say, simple this 30H and going to end at 7FH here. Okay, and at in this slot we are having one location, and that location is a 35H. And at this 35H, suppose the value 09 is present. So what will happen when we execute this first instruction? The content of R0 register are 35H. The value 35H is copied into R0 register. But as here the hash sign is absent, the 35 is considered as a memory location address. So the CPU is going to deal with a data present at this location. So now because of this, the value of R0 register is now 09H. So in this way, with the help of directly using this instruction, we can access a value that present in this scratchpad RAM. Thank you.